Hi, Internet. Welcome to the Grudge Run YouTube channel. It is Thin Lizzy Thursday, and this week is the random song. I have no idea what song we're getting. The computer is choosing, and I've got the random number generator pulled up and some delightful random music for us to listen to while we figure out what the song is. So enjoy this music while the computer overlords decide what Thin Lizzy song or Blast Star Riders or whatever song we're listening to this week. Because we are listening to, by the way, that was, that song was admittedly a little bit of a troll. That is a song called, a composition called Gale by Yasunori Mitsuda, and it is pretty universally despised by a lot of people. Like, it's like, there's just like a lot of vehement hatred towards that song, but it showed up as like, hey, one of the random songs to potentially listen to while the computer figures out what we're doing. And I thought that'd be fun. So this is off Phil's second solo album, and I'm gonna be honest, there's a lot of tracks from this album that I don't really remember, don't listen to that much. Like, there's some very high highs in this album, like some of my favorite stuff Phil has ever done. And then there's a bunch of stuff that just, like, I've completely forgotten. And this falls into the I've completely forgotten category. So, but it's possible that there is some greatness here that I'm just missing. Because that's happened to me with a number of songs in the channel where there have been songs where, like, Call the Police was a song I had just completely forgotten about. And then through doing the reactions, I'm like, oh man, this is great. So, yeah, I'm excited to dive into this. Like I said, I've heard it before, but it's not sticking with me, so I'm excited to dive into it with you guys. So this is Phil's second solo album, and this is Don't Talk About Me, Baby. Yeah, okay, I'm remembering this one. Yeah, this one's good. You know, as far as, you know, musicality to comment on, honestly, like, it's not that different from Phil's writing. It's just, like, some of the instrumentation is a little bit more pop-oriented of the era rather than, like, hard rock. But honestly, like, you just change up the instrumentation and the production, and this is basically a Thin Lizzy song. And, you know, there's not much lyrically thus far. Don't talk about me, baby. Don't talk behind my back. Don't talk about me, baby. Don't talk about me like that. I mean, it's simple, but that simpleness makes it catchy, makes it visceral, where just, like, you're already like, yeah, I'm in. I'm down. I'm vibing with it. Like, it makes you, like, it's very easy to be attracted to the song immediately. We're only 30 seconds in, it's already like, yeah, down with what we're getting. Don't talk about me like that.
Ladies act, it attracts the likes of me and Jack. But in fact, if you check it out, it lacks impact. She'll be hopping and jumping and leaving and lying and crying and dying it every single day. Yeah. I wanna jump, I wanna scream, wanna tell you about my dreams. Gotta get away today. Don't talk about me, baby. Don't talk me off my back. Don't talk about me, baby. Don't talk about me like that.
All right, so, in terms of what we've got going on here, I think the verses are maybe, you know, I'm trying to think. To me, they feel a hair too mellow. I would like build up the energy a little bit more, but also, I think that also comes from me just like not listening to this one. Like, it's not in the rotation, really. And so because of that, like, you're wanting something different from than what it's delivering. But what it's delivering actually isn't bad at all, because what you're really getting with this piece is an emphasis on Phil as, like, as a vocalist, where you get the charisma, the swagger, and really great phrasing, where his voice is just like butter. It's very seductive. It moves you. It keeps you sucked in. But I do think, like, some of the chord choices, I think, like, some of the rhythms, I feel like, are a little bit choppy, a little bit more staccato than I would like with the smoothness of his vocal. But again, what's happening in this piece, like, isn't wrong musically, isn't necessarily a bad choice. It's just I don't know if it's the best choice for this material, necessarily. I think they're just, like, different ways the instruments could have been played, and maybe that could be a little bit less staccato, a little bit more legato, and then I think the piece would flow better with, that is just what I think personally, because I think you do get a very strong melody, so I would want a little bit more energy and, a little bit more legato, but honestly, like, it's still good what we're getting, like, it's still, you know, when it comes to me with songwriting, I think that, in general, it's going to sound stupid, but you want to always try to make the best choice, and not just the choice that you like the most. So, like, what is going to make the song stand out the most and make the song as strong as possible? And so sometimes you might get something like a really creative idea, and it's interesting and it's different, but sometimes the simpler thing would make the song better. And so I'm all about just, like, what is going to make the song the best it can be, rather than what's going to be the most fun to play. And, you know, a lot of musicians don't take that approach, and that's fine, but my thing with music is that, you know, as a guy who's retired from music at this point, but I always try to think listener first, artist second. Like, you want to make something that is just good to listen to, rather than fun to play. Like, that is what my vibe is. And I think the verses fall a little bit more into, like, the fun to play than to fun to listen to. But again, it's not necessarily that it's not fun to listen to. I just think it could be a little bit stronger, but I'm really nitpicking. Lyrics, the ladies act, it attracts the likes of me and Jack, but in fact, if you check it out, it lacks impact. She'll be hopping and jumping and leaving in line and crying and then dying it every single day. I want to jump, I want to scream, I want to tell you about my dreams, got to get away today, eh? I mean, it's like, you know, it's street poetry, it's got that flow, and so, like, it's pretty self-explanatory what the song is about. It's just, you know, about gossip and rumors and just, you know, how that affects you and stuff. And it's pretty clear. And you know, about, like, you know, the response you give to that. But, I mean, it's good. Like, it's a really great vocal. The instrumentation, I think, especially during the chorus, works really well. It's just the verses I could use a little bit more from, but again, it's nitpicking. Because this is good. Like, it's definitely not like bad. It's just like I would have made a couple different choices, but I'm not Phil. So let's rewind, get back to it.
Little silly Willie, he went a little silly, and Willie went out late last night. Now who should meet Willie out with Lily? But a boyfriend Billy late last night. And Billy got a little rough with Lily, till Willie said, "Hey Billy, I think that's enough." Then Billy went silly, he beat little Willie. And Willie, he went out last night. He said, "Don't talk about my baby, don't talk about my back, don't talk about me, baby, don't talk about me like that, don't talk about me, baby, don't talk about my back, don't talk about me."
Okay, so, wow, lots of stuff going on there. This is definitely not a boring song. There's a lot to dig into. The key change there, again, because, like, I have listened to this before, but it's, like I said, it's sort of faded into the background when listening to the entire album. But, you know, that key change was unexpected. Like, a fake Thin Lizzy fan doesn't know how these songs go. But, so the key change was definitely unexpected. But then the lyrics, which I'd never paid as close of attention to, they got dark. So what's funny is like I had locked into the groove of the song, I was vibing with the second verse and being like, yeah, okay. So like the complaints I had were pretty much gone at that point because I was vibing with it. And what Phil has done here is he's doing like this major key kind of happy music with like this little bit of like relaxed reggae beat. And the lyrics are hella dark. And that is actually something musically I do enjoy. Where you've got, like, these really, like, happy, like, bouncy music and really dark, sinister lyrics. I think that is something, like, it is a thing in music that I generally find to be very clever. Because it's also usually very catchy. And I like the sinister nature of it, where it's not, like, condoning what is happening, but it's putting, like, a spotlight on it at a time you're not necessarily expecting it, and I think that that kind of stuff ultimately, like, makes you really think. And so, because you can have, like, a dark, moody song about a sad subject matter, and you're just gonna, like, be wallowing in that the entire time. But I think when you like sneak it in with something like this, I think it like in some ways is even more impactful. So I definitely like that musical trope. I know that is a very divisive musical trope. I know a lot of people who hate it, like really, really hate it. But I am not one of those people. Of course, like depending on like how it's done, like if there's like a glee and like an endorsement of that, then I think there's a problem. But generally, the people who do that, it's more like a critique. But, you know, I'll go into the lyrics. Little silly Willie, he went a little silly, and Willie, he went out late last night. Now, who should meet Willie out with Lily but her boyfriend Billy late last night? Then Billy got a little rough with Lily, so Willie said, "Hey, Billy, I think that's enough." So Billy went silly, he beat Willie, and Willie, he went out last night. So just, like, the fact that, like, you just have this, like, this fight breakout, you know, and just, like, that's just, like, you know, it's so bouncy and so happy, but it just, you've got a fight breaking out in the song. And so I think that is, that's very cool. And actually, I'll admit, as I went through that entire diatribe, I thought that Lily was the one who had gotten beaten. And so I thought, oh, man, that's super dark, Phil. But no, it was just Billy and Willie fighting. So just like two dudes fighting over a girl. So actually way less dark than I thought. So yeah, but still cool because of how close all the rhymes are. Silly, Lily, Willie, Billy. I got a little bit confused there, and my mind went to the dark place. And actually, the song became less interesting than I thought. But still, it was enough to, like, raise my eyebrows and really get me paying attention. So, still cool. Still enjoying the song, but that was an unexpected turn. So a couple things. The solo was fine. It was a pretty unremarkable solo given the general catalog of solos that Phil Lynott has. Like, when you look at his career with Thin Lizzy, and then even with a lot of his solo stuff, that guitar solo was just like, it was fine. Like, it wasn't a bad solo, but just like, man, if you're soloing with Phil Lynott, the dude has had Gary Moore solo for him and John Sykes solo for him. So, like, there's going to be scrutiny. And so it's like, yeah, that's fine, I guess. Other things I will say. I like that Phil wore guyliner. Good for you, Phil. I also have worn guyliner many a time and think it's awesome. But also, this just, like, trolled me really, really hard. The Phil Lynott, like, official YouTube channel for, like, the uploads of his music has 1,750,000 subscribers. I'm at, like, 1,450,000 subscribers. So, he's got, like, 1,750. I've got, like, 1,450, you know, ish. That is gross. How close I am into subscribers to the Phil Lynott, like, official YouTube uploads. In the sense that I think that Phil should have way more. And that, based upon, like, the statistical growth of this channel, like, assuming I continue it past Thin Lizzy Thursdays and do something else after, you know, we're done with this in, like, 3 years or 4 years or whatever, I will surpass that sub growth. I hope his channel grows at a faster rate than mine. Because I think that is, like, gross how few subs Phil Lynott official has. It says Phil Lynott topic, but, like, that should not be the case. I should not be, like, neck and neck with Phil, in terms of subscribers. You know, Thin Lizzy has way more subs than that, obviously, but still. Actually, how many subs does Thin Lizzy have? Obviously, Thin Lizzy topic would be different. How many subs you got, Lizzy? 64,000. I'm probably not going to eclipse that for maybe my entirety of my YouTube quote-unquote career. But yeah, so that is Don't Talk About Me, Baby. Another cool song. Let's see where we rank it. Where do we put Don't Talk About Me, Baby? Okay. Yeah, this is probably B rank. Yeah, I'm gonna put it right below Solo in Soho. The thing is, when I just listen to these songs, sometimes I get pretty hot on them. I'm just like, yeah, let's like, you know, shoot it up to S rank, man. But then I'm like, no, I need to, just because I'm like coming off it fresh. And I'm just like, yeah, that was really good. But like realistically, there's so many better songs that Phil has done over the years, and I think that there's a reason why this one got lost in the shuffle for me. It's not bad, but I can definitely see how this one is like, oh yeah, I can see how I didn't go back to this one all the time. But that said, because it's like it's fresh with me right now, and I spent a lot of time just like really soaking it in, it's going to be in the rotation. It's going to be on the playlist. But so I'm definitely glad I didn't. That's the great thing about this is doing this channel is that I'm really getting to savor and appreciate each one, like, you know, like a fine wine or a steak, like a, you know, a really well done steak. Says the guy who became a vegetarian like 2 months ago. But back when I ate meat, the delicious steak. I did not realize how strong the vegetarianness had become. Where like I felt even bad saying that. It's weird. It's weird to like to finally do it because I thought about going vegetarian for years, and then I was like, but I like the taste too much and the health benefits, and then I just did it, and it's like, it's weird, man. It's freaking weird to just like to have done it, but like I still eat burgers all the time because like there's just like really banging veggie burgers that basically taste like burgers, and it's just like up. Oh, it's like my diet really hasn't changed that much. It's like it's still pizza and burgers. It's just like, you know, instead of pepperoni, I'm just mushrooms. Anyway, ranting over. I want to know what you guys think of this one in the comments down below, and make sure you, person I am pointing at, you vote in the poll, because next up is the audience vote, the community vote, to see what song we're doing next, so vote, and comment, and like, and sub. Alright, that's the video. Bye, everyone.